Hello and welcome to LibreCAD tutorial. Today I want to draw a pickup truck. I got the image from studycadcam.com. Thank you studycadcam.com. Okay, please open your LibreCAD application on your desktop, and then for the first please activate some snap functions here. There are free snap, snap on endpoints, snap center, snap middle, and snap intersection. Okay, let me start to draw. Start with a big rectangle here. Okay, select rectangle. Left click it anywhere on your screen. Go to command line form and type the dimension for the rectangle. The dimension is for horizontal is 75 and for vertical is 57. So type at the command line form add 75 comma 57 and press enter. Okay, right click to escape from the rectangle tool. Now I think we continue with this part. Okay, I want to use parallel line tool. Select parallel. For the first distance is 6.5. Go to the distance box here. 7.5, and left click near the bottom of our rectangle before. And then the next distance is 5. Type 5 on the box at the top here, 5, and left click near the line we created before. Next, 7.2. Type 7.2 and left click near the line or created before. Okay, and right click on your mouse to escape from the parallel line tool. Okay, next I think we should create this line before. The distance is 6. In the same way, use parallel line tool. Type 6 for the distance and left click near the rectangle here. Okay, okay, next right click to escape. I think we should extend this line. Okay, just edit the end of the line. Bring the end of the line here longer than the line before. Okay, to make it easy, please activate restrict vertical. Okay, and then press escape on the keyboard. Next, now we know the distance here, 74.5. Select parallel line 74.5 and left click near the line here. Okay, right click to escape. Okay, now time to use trim tool. Select trim tool. Left click for the first line here. Left click at the second line here, and then right click now. Okay, oh, right click again. Select again trim tool. Okay, left click for the first line here. Left click for the second line here. Okay, left click again, left click. Okay, and then right click to escape. Okay, we have created this part. Okay, next we can draw this part. Okay, the distance from the line here is 19. So select again parallel line tool and type the distance 19. Left click near the line here. Okay, and then right click on your mouse to escape, and then edit the line. Please activate restrict vertical before, and then bring the end of the line far from the origin. Okay, next. Okay, we got the point here, so we can create a circle. Okay, first circle is the diameter is 8, and the next circle the diameter is 22. So we can create the circles. Select circle center point. Okay, oh, please deactivate restrict vertical before, and left click at the point here, and the first circle is the diameter is 8, so the radius we have to type the radius here. The radius will be 4, a half of 8. Okay, the next circle's diameter is 22, so the radius is 11. Type 11 for the radius and press enter, and then right click to escape. Okay, now we can create the shape. The distance from the shape before is 62. We can copy the shapes. Okay, but before we copy, we can make it perfect before. Select the line here, we don't need it anymore. Press delete on the keyboard. Okay, the line also, and then select trim tool. We have to remove unnecessary part of this rectangle. Oh, sorry, this circle. Left click at the line here as a trim line or cutter line, and then left click at the circle we want to trim. Okay, right click to escape. I think we should delete this part also, so we'll use divide tool. Select divide, left click at the line, left click at the point here, left click again at the line, left click at the point, and then right click. Now select the line we want to delete and press delete on the keyboard. Okay, we can copy the object or the shapes into the position like this. The distance is 62. Okay, select the shapes and then select move or copy, left click at the reference point, maybe here, and then go to command line form, type add negative 62, 0 and press add negative 62, 0 and press enter. Select keep original and click OK. Press escape on the keyboard, and then okay, we can bring this line into the position. Okay, touch the circle here. Okay. Okay, I think we should draw this part. The distance is 27. So I want to create a vertical line. The length is okay, 100. And then put the line here, right click, and then select parallel line, type the distance is 27. Okay, and left click near the vertical line, okay, and then right click. Okay, now we can create line from this point into the vertical line, but we have to activate restrict horizontal and then activate snap on entity. Okay, left click at the end of this and then we can delete the vertical line here. Okay, next we can create this part. Okay, yeah, I think we should use parallel line again. Select parallel, and then the distance is 57.5. Type the distance 57.5, and then left click near the line here. Okay, right click. Now we can create this. This line, select trim tool, left click at the vertical line here as a limiting line, and then left click at the line we want to extend. Okay, right click. Okay, we can delete this line, select trim, left click at the trim line here, and left click at the line we want to trim, right click again. Okay, this is I think the difficult part. There is no data about the distance for this line, so we have to create this line before. Yeah, okay. To create this line, we need this angle 116, and the length for the line here 32.7. Okay, we can use tool relative angle. Select relative angle, and then type the angle here 116. Oh, we should use negative because the angle 116, and type the length 32.7. okay, and then left click the line here. Okay, oh, we should deactivate restrict horizontal and snap on entity. Now bring now put the line into the into, okay, put the line. Oh, you can put the line at anywhere before. Right click to escape. Now we have to create this this part. Yeah, use parallel line again, select parallel for the first distance is 12, type 12, and left click near the line here, and the next distance is 17, type 17, and left click near the line before, right click. Now we should use the 2 points line to draw the line here manually. Okay, right click, right click again, and then select the angle line we have created before. Select move or copy tool, left click at the reference point, bring the line into the position like this. Okay, left click, and then select the original, click OK. Next, press escape on the keyboard. Select trim 2. Okay, left click for the first line, left click at the second line. Okay, yeah. And then right click. Okay, we can create this this part. So okay, there is data about here the distance from this line 6. Use parallel tool, parallel line tool again. Type the distance 6. Left click near the line here, and then right click. Okay, and then the distance here is 17. Okay, use parallel tool again. Select parallel, and then type 17. Left click near the vertical line here. Right click to escape. Okay, now select trim 2. We should delete the unnecessary lines. Okay, select trim 2 and left click, left click, left click again, left click. Okay, right click now. Oh, select again trim 2. I forget it. Okay, right click. Okay, next. Yeah, we've to create this line. Okay, I think the distance 18.2, and the angle is same with the angle line we have created before. Okay, there is an easy way to just take the angle line we have created before, and then select move or copy, left click at the reference point here, and let's bring the line into the position like this. Okay, select keep original and click OK. Press escape on the keyboard. We can delete this line, and then select trim 2. Okay, we can remove unnecessary lines here. Okay, right click. Yeah, almost done. Now we will give a color for the truck. Select all the drawing, and then select hatch tool here. Okay, mark the solid fill, and mark the enable preview. You can see the color is blue. It is the color follow the color of our layer. So if you want to change the color, please change the layer color here. Okay, click OK. Okay. Yeah, we have finished our job for today. Okay, thank you. I think that's all for today. Thank you very much. See you at next video. Please subscribe to our channel to help us to improve and to continue this project. Thank you very much. Bye.